Hey guys, you recruiters, and welcome to my FIFA 16 Juventus Scrummo, where last time off I picked up a huge win in the Champions League, securing my qualification and then progression to the knockout stages of the Champions League with two games to spare in the group stage, and I also picked up another win in the league. In this episode, this is the first episode where you will get three league matches. There is a game against Seville that I'm just going to sim because it has no meaning. Like I just said, I'm already qualified. And it's mostly thanks to Juan Cuadrado, who, as you can see, after his hat-trick against Borussia Mönchengladbach back in the last episode. If you didn't see that, go back and watch it. It was pretty impressive. Cuadrado is now in the starting lineup. If he can impress me enough, then I won't replace him in the January transfer window, which was my intent. But after that hat trick, I'm starting to have a second now. Out. And in the second match of this episode, simply, I am playing AC Milan. As you know, I'm only 5 points ahead of Milan, and I would love to make it 8. Maybe even they could drop points beforehand. I know they're playing Atlantia, who are not easy to play against by any stretch of the imagination. There's no easy team to play against in any league in the world. Well, especially not in Italy. So, I expect Atlantia to give Milan a good run for their money. And to give them a tough game. So hopefully he was
with a demoralized defense. They've let in so many goals.
When I beat Empoli, who, as you can see, he have the least goals in Serie A with 21 compared to my 25. It's only 4 difference. I guess there's not a lot of high scoring teams in the league. To be honest, I was probably the worst. The lowest scoring team in the league until recently. I fixed that though. So it's not impossible. It's not impossible, Empoli. So don't threat too much. You just need to maybe a good signing in the January transfer window will give them what they need. Who knows? That's none of my business, though. Oh, well, I'm Juventus manager, not Empoli manager. There's Pogba. Wow, that's an early yellow card. What an idiot!
No hesitation.
Like,
the yellow card's coming out even this early in the game.
I don't know what Andre Costa was thinking. Another goddamn Costa. How many are there? Probably should leave this to a right footer, like Paul Pogba.
A good hit at it, but I'm afraid that was off the right.
That didn't go as well as that didn't go at all as I planned or imagined. That went horribly. That went horribly wrong.
Giving the opposition a problem with their interpassing.
Yeah, I won't be doing that again if I get another free kick in that position.
Now the shot! A decent effort, just off target.
Yeah, unlucky because he got some power behind the ball, just not the direction.
Sandro.
Well, the Juventus players arriving here today full of confidence. You can understand that.
Yeah, block there by the Empoli defender. It's come to Pogba, and he lost it straight away. Brilliant, Paul. You know, just, you know, we're not trying to accomplish anything here at all. Oh, no. No, it's just my imagination that I want to actually accomplish something. Go on, Tolisso. Oh, buries it in the corner. What a goal. Another goal by the youngster. He is impressive.
And look at the net pulled in there.
If great pass by Sami Khedira, who's probably going to get an assist for that. I'd like to think he'd get an assist for that. Third goal for Tolisso in the
scoring. 1-0 here.
Serie A, his fourth Juventus goal, because he does have one in the Champions League.
Now, what is the referee going to do here?
So, yeah, not a bad start. Hard when you're at such a young age in a new country. Of course, Tolisso was French. I'm assuming Paul Pogba is helping him set it. I'd imagine that's how it works.
Juventus regain possession here.
It's probably good to have someone who is from the same country can speak to Tolisso. He probably doesn't speak English. He does score goals. Oh, he spagged another one.
And he knew exactly where the keeper was there. He knew he didn't.
Oh, I don't know if he speaks English. I don't know the man. Great pass from Anderson.
Well, there's a goal worth.
And then Tolisso took a few touches and then buried it. Very persistent from the young Frenchman. And that is very good. That's what I want to see.
2-0.
When I make my signs in the January transfer window, I'm probably going to be unbeatable. Because I'm I can already see this team is good. It's on the cusp of being as good as I want it to be. Is that not a foul there on Cuadrado? Really? That's not. That wasn't a foul.
See it again. I bet you do too.
Yeah, sign of a bit of experience there. Didn't try and put his foot through it. Knew exactly where we wanted to place
Okay, referee. I'll take your word for it.
No nonsense defending from him.
Tolisso for the hat trick. Oh, imagine. Oh, he's confident now. Two goals will do that for you. Kadira, yay! I think that's his first goal. Oh, over the club, is it? I'm trying to think, has he scored yet? I don't think so. I think that is his first goal. At least for me, it's his first goal. But I don't know if he scored in real life. I'm not really following Juventus. I know they had a bad start and they're now turning it around. Other than that, I'm not really following Serie A. I'm more focused on how bad Liverpool are doing. Which reminds me, these Juventus screw modes, they're pre-recorded. This is being recorded on the Saturday. Actually, they're both recorded on Saturday, one after the other. But in between videos, I will check on Liverpool, because right now they should have kicked off by now against Norwich. But the way we're playing at the moment, I wouldn't be surprised if we lost. But then again, Liverpool could surprise us all and win. That's how random they've been this season. What's not random is a very good first league goal for Philippe Anderson. And yeah, he got his goal in the Champions League, but finally, granted the keeper wasn't exactly in a position to stop the ball going in, but
let's see the replay now.
You're not going to hear me complain. That's in the back of the net. Is it 4-0 or more after losing track? Yeah, it's 4-0. It's 4-0 just before halftime.
Start to the game from the team that's taking them to the cleaners. And that whistle
and
time for break is halftime.
I am having a blast. Now, let's see. Yes, Milan are drawing with Atlantia. Come on, Atlantia. If Milan drop points, then I'll go into my game against them. See, I'm 5 ahead of them right now. That'd be 2 extra points. So that'd be 7. I could make it a 10-point gap between me and Milan over 2 games. Come on, that has to be a foul, right? No, that's... Wow, this is just... I just don't understand. What? What do you have to do to get a foul? We'll get him in this game, huh? And I'm pretty sure that was a corner, ref. That was a corner. Cellini's shot was blocked by the Empoli defender. No, it wasn't. Go absolutely fuck yourself. You stupid... I was going to say racist. I don't know why I was going to say racist. Maybe he doesn't like Irish people. That racist cunt. Ah.
Now looking ahead on EA Sports and our football coverage.
I should have known. It's because I'm Irish. I don't know. I say some weird shit. I don't know. I'm a bit random, in case you didn't know. If you're new here, I'm a bit random. I'm a bit on the random side.
Simple for the goalkeeper.
Like that first instance. Why did I do that? Why did I actually do that? That was a bit on the random side itself. Cuadrado, who's been fouled twice by this Mario Rui guy. And there's no one there to put in Cuadrado's cross. You may as well pass to no one.
Well, he's hit it hard that I think it might have just dipped over the keeper at the last minute.
I should have figured the hat-trick may have been a one-time deal. I'm not going to jump to conclusions yet. I'm going to give Cuadrado a chance, because I don't see Morata scoring any goddamn hat-tricks. He barely gets three shots on goal in the game. In a game he plays in. Like, if he got three shots, chances are, or most of them would be rebounds. Seriously. I don't know what it is, but Morata it almost seems like he's lazy under me. I mean, he's not lazy he's not Christian Benteke lazy, but he's seeming a bit lazy, you know? Maybe he'd be doing better if I was in a 4-4-2. I have considered going to the 4-4-2, but I don't really want to play Paul Pogba at CAM anymore. I mean, he's having the time of his life in his regular central midfield position.
It's a corner again.
This 4-3-3, it's just working.
Khedira! That's safely away.
You know? And why mess with something that's working? That's bound to get disastrous results. And of course, you've been to have fouled that defender. I think it was actually that Costa guy who fouled. Oh yeah. Earlier in the game, yeah, it was.
Andrea Costa. Macaroni. Well, we've only got 7 minutes remaining now.
Pogba. Dybala tries to get the. I got away from the defender and got the shot away. But straight to the keeper. Because I'm brilliant. Like that. Teammate. No. No, no, no. Yes. Cuadrado, come on. Come on. It's your chance. Pogba. Pogba! Way! Cuadrado gets the assist and Paul Pogba scores. Yeah, it's been the. They have the French really. Against Empoli, because both my French players have scored. Tolisso got the first, when Pogba's finished them off. Goals from my
the margin that they lead by.
Yeah, it's not always easy coming
German center, defensive mid, Khedira and Anderson. And make it a little less French, but no. 3 of 5. Now, show me some good news. Yes, Atlantia beat him! They beat him! Dropped 3 points.
Hello,
Yes, thank you, Atlantia. Yeah. Yo, it's gonna be. It's gonna be 11 points. It's gonna be 11 points.
Verona 2, Roma 1.
Like, that is unreal.
2, Fiorentina 0. Let's have a look at what those results mean for tonight's league tables. At the top of the table remain Juventus with 36 points. In second, AC Milan with 28 points. In third, Lazio with 21 points. In
fourth, I noticed Anderson's passing needs a bit of work, so that's why I'm putting him in. Points.
In sixth, moving down, are Palermo with 19 points.
You couldn't have gone up to a 53.
Roma with 18 points.
Really?
Rising up the table are
you were quite welcome, Cadrado. And I'm definitely going to keep you in the squad as long as you keep
third bottom,
performing well.
The table are Sampdoria with 10 points. Bottom and falling are Bologna with 12 points.
Oh, it was 24 goals they conceded. Oh, that's my bad. It's 21 goals they conceded. That was what I was thinking. They were very low for 24 goals. Or 21 goals, sorry. My bad. I guess it doesn't matter. That was what I was thinking. They had scored a lot more goals than they did. Sorry to get your hopes up, Empoli fans. You weren't playing that good, as it turns out. Oh, he's gone on international duty, has he? Skip it. Surely up. Bahouli. I'm probably saying this guy's name wrong. Yes, that youngster's gone up to 53. It's good. My that young goalkeeper is almost a 69 rated player now. And it's time for the game against me. Oh, come on! Who got injured? Is it? If it's Cuadrado, oh, his career is over. Or here. It is! Are you shitting me? Well, Churchill isn't playing anyway, but Cuadrado, you were just on a good streak, and now you get injured. Nah. Nah, I'm gonna have to bring in someone in the window. It looks like that signing of a guy from, I'm forgetting his name. But it looks like Cuadrado's time at Juventus was short-lived. There's me thinking he might... What's that guy's name again? Berardi. Thank you. Not gonna cancel his loan just yet, but unfortunately, this injury means Morata is gonna come back into the side. Which isn't, you know, it's not necessarily a bad thing. He's just not been playing to standard. Hurt. I just really don't want to play him over there on the left side because he seems really goddamn lazy when he does play there. Of course he got injured. I knew it would be Cuadrado. Oh, I should have placed the bet on it. Anyway, can't focus on that. I'll focus on being Milan, going 11 points clear, and looking good. to retain the Serie A title.
Juventus lineup then. Gigi Buffon.
Who knows? Maybe Morata can do something to make me change my mind about him. But at the moment, I only see him as a substitution or player to use whenever Dybala is tired. He actually just scored, but he's offside, of course, because. Why not? But at least it's good to see him actually getting into a position where he can score, so that's a nice change. Yeah, I'll take that free kick.
Giving the player the benefit of the doubt about that, but he's given the free kick.
Can whip the ball into the box and get a transfer whispers header into the back of the net.
Position here, and there's a new man in between the posts today.
Yeah, and here is a keeper that likes to command.
Won't get into the box.
So I think it'd be a good addition.
And it's clear because it's brilliant.
And the cross comes in now. Comes out with a punch.
But I will take a corner. I will definitely take a corner. I scored from a corner against Stempley. And it was Khedira again.
Corner has been wasted because it's gone.
May have been fouled. Obviously not in the referee's game, he wasn't.
Juventus regain.
Are you shaming me? Sorry about that.
Possession here. Got the ball away from the danger momentarily, but it is a corner following that good tackle.
Come on, Dybala, whip it in. Oh, off the bar! Come on! Giuliani! He put it over the fucking bar!
Sure, we're going to get a better occasion, although the football purists loved it actually. That 2003
that is not a position you want your center back in,
which didn't have a goal and went to a penalty shootout. I think we'll get goals today.
Well, we've got some wonderful strikers there before. No one wanted to run for the goddamn ball. Why
anticipating a goalless draw?
Headed
Marlow,
where a teammate can gather the ball.
Tolisio Anderson, come on, whip the ball. Go in,
gonna cross it.
Pogba!
That was off the radar. We can, Alan, revisit the effort from earlier from Giorgio Chiellini.
Quick reactions by him to get there first, and a good header, bit unlucky.
Yeah, how much will I regret that miss? I'm guessing probably a good bit.
Iconic, of course, the red and black.
Tolisio. Anderson. Come on.
History. They have got a great history.
But then?
Back in the 80s and 90s, they had those wonderful sides littered.
Tolisio!
World-class talent.
Why? What was... What? Why was play stopped?
The offside. Stops the play. Flag went up. Referee blocked.
Oh, for sake! Yes! They made a huge mistake! And I hit it straight at the keeper! Why? Why did I hit it straight at the goddamn keeper?
Ignacio Abate.
Anywhere else! And that's in the back of the net! God damn it!
Mario Balotelli. Attacking now.
Kedira.
Tackle to break up the play.
Please, Trudeau, please be onside.
There's a chance.
That's Tolisso. Yes! The 11-point gap is going to be real. Oh, and it's Tolisso again. Three goals in two games. And he did this a few games ago when he scored in back-to-back matches. And now he has scored in back-to-back matches again. This is probably his most crucial goal. Oh, a very critical. Goal. Well, that could end up putting me 11 points clear at the top of Serie A. Dybala. Oh.
Juventus will get the throw.
He got it clear, Dix. Come on. The blood is fresh, boys. He's Anderson straight to the goddamn keeper, of course. Why not? You know, that's pretty much what we do most. You know, just give the keeper the ball because, you know, he needs a few touches. You know, just make sure he doesn't fall asleep. Pogba. Tolisso. Anderson. Come on. Corner. I'll take the corner.
A clear corner.
Come on, Pogba. Whip it in. Yes! It's in! It's Dybala! Pablo Dybala bangs it in. It's 2-0. It's going to be 11 points. Suck on that, Milan. And the title is staying where it belongs in Turin with Juventus. The old lady isn't giving up the crown.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
She's taking it and he's keeping it forever.
No shots at all so far for Milan.
I don't know where I'm going with this.
Before the game is out, the fans are absolutely furious.
Chiellini. Sandro. Can I get a third goal before? For half time, it's Morata. Come on.
Morata.
Nope, straight at the keeper.
Straight at the goalkeeper.
May as well, because everyone else is kicking it straight at the goddamn keeper. Except two.
And there goes the whistle.
Two exceptions. Those two exceptions are two fist pumping goals that are putting me 11 points clear.
45 minutes still to go. Second half underway.
Where is your response, AC Milan? Huh? Where is it? I don't see it. Come on. Go for the jugger. I want to get a third goal and just finish them off. Morata. Come on. Morata, you can get there.
There's the ball in.
The cross. Pogba. Yes. An assist for Morata. A goal. Oh, for Pogba, he's scored two in two games now.
To the left-hand side.
Oh, and he's gotten that third goal I wanted. Not sure how he got that in, but I don't care. The important thing is that he did. He got it in. And job done, really. 3-0. Yeah.
The other very off-colour. Alex. Ignacio Abate. Morata.
Dybala. Dybala. Oh, it's the bar. Kedira will put it in. Kedira will put it in.
For Juventus, an important goal. It really should wrap up the game.
Dybala could have gotten his second of the game, but he hits the post.
That's it for them.
It comes to Kedira. He's not going to miss that. There's nobody there to stop him from missing it. Kedira gets his second. Everyone is scoring two consecutive games. The only person who hasn't is Anderson. And Dybala got the goal instead of him. Well, there will be a third game, so there's still a chance for him to get two goals in this episode. And this game isn't exactly over. Well, it's over in a contest standpoint, but it's the match itself is still going strong.
Now they've run the ball back and trying to make something of it quickly.
Morata.
Getting in the way there was Alex.
Why? Why did I do that?
Nigel De Jong. Substitution for Milan. We'll put this match in your diary. EA Sports presentation of the Champions Cup fixture. Juventus, they'll be facing Sevilla away from home.
Yeah, high quality.
Just the this one. There won't be much quarter game. Up and come fixture against Sevilla, as I mentioned earlier. Heard that will be simmed because it's not really necessary to play it. And Dybala did his get his second goal. Does get his second goal this time around. And 5-0 for the second consecutive game. It seems now it's starting to seem like it was ages ago that I couldn't score more than one goal in a match.
Milan, their next game, Alan.
Well, they're playing Sampdoria, Martin, in the next match in Serie A, and I can only see one winner. I think now
it's the confidence. All you need is a bit of confidence, and that can go a long way.
Morata.
It's something Liverpool certainly need to learn in their life. Hopefully, that's a penalty. Thank you very much, and that's probably a red card too, because my player didn't have the ball. Ref probably would have been a goal anyway. A yellow? How is that a yellow? Oh, come on. Send him off. I'm sure Abate was probably hoping he'd get out of here sooner. That's probably why he went for this stupid challenge. I mean, he clearly saw Morata didn't have them all, and he decided, you know what? This match is over. I'm going to get out of here. Just get a red card and
we're going to have
get myself sent off. Just, nah, not interested in seeing this out. Dybala looking for another hat trick, and yes, unfortunately for Milan, and that usually means a big scoreline. It's 6-0.
Well, no wonder he's wheeling away in a super celebration.
16th
to get a hat trick is a fantastic experience, and he's just done that.
Well, having scored two,
another
he's just
hat
so
trick.
Full of confidence, and he's never looked like
four.
This
I think
that
that's three or four now really this today. Season.
The other very off colour.
He doesn't mess around. When he gets two, he almost always gets three. Well, he always does get three. Yeah, I can't think of a game lately where he got two and didn't get the third.
Sami Khedira.
Hurt for some reason.
That's the way to do it, I would say.
None come to mind.
Here, they've not given the opposition a sniff. Although we've got a few.
Only two players have scored a hat trick for me so far in this career mode, and that's Dybala and Cuadrado.
Bonaventura.
I think I'll be sending Cuadrado back to Chelsea.
Abate.
He'll probably be in a body cast with the way he's going, but he'll still be sent back.
Okay.
All I know is I will not be sad to see him go. Not with the way he's getting injured.
Well. Montalivo.
Daba.
And the goalkeeper got a touch to the
Khedira, come on. Pay attention, Sammy. Well, it doesn't matter. There's the full-time whistle. Oh, Dybala gets another match ball. Oh, you're going to run out of places to keep him at this rate. Each Paulo? Oh. I mean, that's like I said, that's three or four. I've lost track how many
Bologna 0.
He scored. Roma, that's how many he has scored.
Juventus 6.
When I've lost track, it's not a good sign. It's not. Well, actually, it is. No. The more
Juventus with 39 points.
Or hat tricks, the better. Really?
With 28 points.
And third, Lazio with 21 points. He did. Rising up the table are Roma grow, with 21, which is good. No. Fifth and I can put
Verona with 20 points. In sixth, moving down, are Napoli with 20 points.
Anderson back in.
In seventh and falling,
get his
Palermo
passing up,
with
as I plan to do anyway.
In eighth, Hellas Verona with 18 points. Bottom of the table, Frosinone with 7 points. Third bottom, Sampdoria with 10 points.
Just simulate the game. Please, no injuries.
Fifth bottom, Udinese.
Well, Cuadrado's not playing, so I don't think I should. I don't have much to worry about. 1-1 draw. Tolisso, he scored again! Tolisso scored again! That's 3 games in a row! Oh, and Bonucci got himself sent off. For what? He didn't even injure anyone! There wasn't any penalty. What did you do? Ooh, that is baffling. I'm not sure how he managed that, but congratulations, Spinucci, you're an idiot.
Arsenal 0, Barcelona 2, Atletico Madrid 1, Bayern Munich 2, Manchester City 3, Borussia Mönchengladbach 1, Rome 2, Chelsea 1.
Just in time before the game against Parma. Did I say that right? Palmero. Well, they are 7th, so that's not going to be a particularly easy game. They'll ball against his former club in their bright pink, because reasons. I mean, why not? If they wear pink, I'm not going to say that they're wrong. Sorry, finishing off my bottle of water. In case you heard that, that's what that sound was.
Hi there, everybody. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith has joined me for this Serie A game today.
Pleasure to be here.
Go for 3 victories from 3. Well,
game today is.
No, I was going to say 4. I didn't beat Sevilla. Yeah, it was a draw.
This
is actually the first draw. The first time I didn't win it.
Go into today, Alan. A version of 4-4-2. He's given the free kick, but no sign of the card. Maybe he just wants to make sure he's not made a rod for his own back.
Wonder, doesn't it? It's not going to affect us.
It's just working out which way it is.
Like I said, that game didn't matter. Really, that was a point game for Hill. Well, there was 3 available to him.
Share the opinion that the best is still to come from.
I wouldn't have cared if I lost that match, because it would not matter. Superbly.
It seems if it's on a string at times.
This could be a chance.
Morata, come on. This is your chance, Silver.
Morata!
Blocked. Are you sitting? Come on, get in the corner. Me, Marta.
Well, as blocks go, that's a good one. And there is some
Pogba. Whip it in. Position.
He's gonna cross it. They stop the ball coming in. Oh, in goes the cross.
Malo. Ooh.
Goalkeeper hasn't had to move for that.
Malo came all the way up from the back. And he almost scored.
Juventus looking for a victory.
Anderson making himself a nuisance up in the box as well. Chiellini. Sandro.
Morata. Played into the middle.
Yes! Dybala with another goal.
What about the celebration?
Oh, just pile them on.
Tell you a little something about
and Paolo, just pile them on. And, sorry if you don't like the fact that he celebrated against Palmeiro. Oh, I don't know how to do that hands up celebration. Just think of him as Andy Carroll.
Cut out the pass.
Who just doesn't give a shit.
Now can go on the attack, maybe. Space for the
shot. Oh, another goal. Oh, for him. Oh, which is bad news for Palmeiro, because, like I said in the last match, when he gets two, he usually gets a third. Side of the goal, it's wonderful technique.
Restarting at 2-0.
He doesn't usually get them this quick, to be honest. One directly after the other. Anderson. The ball. Finds his way and he stops.
Alberto Gilardino.
Kadira. Oof. This man scored in both the other games against Milan and against midfield. Well read by Empoli. So
in that part of the pitch.
Okay, easily. He got himself a goal. Won this match
they
too.
With it well defensively. That will end the threat.
Dive was not good. And it's to complete his hat trick. Nah. They fouled me, I guess. I didn't see that. Kadira.
Sami Kadira.
To Pogba.
He could lay it off to the supporting player.
I must score. Julien.
Right down the slot for the goalkeeper.
Ah!
Quick header. Found the team.
Daba. Is the hat trick here? Nope. Straight at the keeper.
He was really exposed.
Yeah, it was a good break, and you did fancy the player bearing down on goal, but fair play to the keeper.
Rata wins the header. Hurts back in the ball, and he's offside.
Get the ball, and that's been judged by the officials as offside. Looked clear enough.
Rata.
Well, he slipped his man. Well, he could be in.
Rata! That was... Oh, my God.
Because that is, well, horrendous.
He's going to get some stick for that. Even more if they end up losing this match.
Maresca. He's spotted a teammate and he's got the technique as well as the vision to switch the play. Francesco Bolzoni. Half time now.
See, Milan are playing Sampdoria, but they're not. They haven't kicked off yet.
They decided to make a change, and being behind, you can understand that.
Now that I've beaten them, it's more a point of me winning and rather than me caring about whether they drop points or not. 7 minutes playing,
1-1. Thank you very much, Alan. On the cross, blocked well by the defender. Well, it didn't quite cause the problems that it looked as though it would, that cross. And now the defending team can play their way out of trouble.
Anderson is going to get there. Is he going to get his goal? How did the keeper save that? Pogba. Anderson. Sorry, that's Tolisso. Well, I was expecting Anderson to be there. Tolisso going out wide. Not post with. Anderson is moving to a different location to get himself in a better position. And why not? Malo.
News of a goal from Torino.
Anderson.
Goal for Bologna. 60 minutes played. 1-0.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual.
Closing down, closing down.
Coming up, of course, EA Sports presenting the Serie A fixture. Palermo will be facing Atalanta away.
Can't get the ball.
Given their respective
form, all the way before he's tackled.
Big 3 points at stake.
Maresca.
Legendary computer is good at keeping possession. I'll give him that. They're very hard to tackle.
Gonzalez.
All the times. It's almost to a frustrating level. Almost.
Tried his luck from a long way.
Seriously, out. Why did you hit it straight at the keeper? Dealing with it.
What about
I was holding
match, Alan.
The thing as far to the right as I could. Are you shitting me? No, 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 get that out of here. No, I have not conceded a league goal yet, and I will not concede one through who EA BS.
Waving quite a few defenders forward. Just going to get that ball into the box.
Nah.
Possible.
Good play by the defenders, really, to force that
goal kick. Just what I need.
A long way wide.
Reevaluate.
These shapes completely.
Should not have played that short. That was way too dangerous. Go on, Anderson. It might work out, though. Anderson. In. Oh, a good save by the keeper. But the corner has been won. In. In. Get the ball. Oh, it's Dybala. His moment against his former club. Ah, out for another corner. This time on the opposite side.
Of the defender, it will be a corner.
Pogba straight over the bar.
Just clinch it. That's what they're looking for.
Great. I think this is going to be one of those rare games. I think this is going to be the first time he's not going to get the hat trick.
Rigoni.
So two consecutive hat tricks in the league. Not going to happen. And it looks like.
Maresca. Well, none of his teammates.
Unless I can make an attack from this goal kick. I'm gonna try it though. Anderson is offside. Brilliant. Nah, that's it. That's probably gonna be game over. No? Let play, ref! Let play! Hey, Dybala! Still there. He's offside.
Well, he's caught offside, trying to get in behind. He'll say that the pass should have come a bit earlier.
No, the hat trick. My beautiful hat trick. No, not the hat trick.
Great day for them to win the game and keep the opposition out.
Yeah, it was job done, wasn't it? The opposition weren't at their best today, but you still have to beat them.
Well, I come. This is my goal of winning all three games in this episode. So, yeah. And I'm now 11 points clear of Milan. Maybe even 14. Who knows? Maybe Sampdoria beat them.
Chievo Verona. Udinese, 1.
Would I ever beat that? Not lucky.
Hellas Verona, 2.
No is the answer to that.
Sampdoria, 1.
They beat them 2-1.
Nil. Juventus, 2.
Oh well, 11 points is good too, right? Now let's see what effect that yes is the answer. The standings.
At the top of the table remain Juventus.
Thanks for watching this episode. Oh, I hope you enjoy it. Smash the like button if you did. Hit subscribe for more, and until next time, I will see you.
In fourth,
hold on. But until then, peace.